trainer Jeanette Jenkins, and welcome to FitOn. We are about to get into a sexy arms, abs, and legs workout. So let's do this. You're gonna need some light weights, threes, fives, maybe even eights, and a mat. And enjoy yourself, have a good time. If you're a beginner and you haven't worked out before or that often, just listen to your body. For everyone, take a break whenever you need it, modify whatever you need to, and just make sure you have a good time. Take those legs nice and wide. We're gonna warm up. Just give me a slow squat. Send those hips back. Keep those knees behind the toes. Now let's get the arms involved. Reach up overhead. You got it. As you sit back into these squats and reach up, I just want you to give me a few nice deep breaths. Inhale, exhale. Two more nice deep breaths. One more time. Now let's alternate arm reaches overhead. Just lengthen out through the lats. Warm those shoulders up. But I still want you to come down into those legs so we get that body nice and warm. Now reach the arms in front of you. Good job, little rotation through the torso. Warm up through those hips and the lower back. And now side to side through the legs. Just stretch out through those adductors. Push those hips back. Reach all the way across to those opposite toes. Keep the spine nice and long. Push the chest through. And just keep breathing. Your heart rate's getting a little elevated. That's a good thing. Give me four more. Two. One more time. Place your hands on your thighs and just give me some cat-cow stretches warming up through that back, round the spine. Two more. Now roll it all the way up. Inhale up, exhale, come all the way down into a squat. Walk the hands out into a plank. Brace your abs. Walk it back in, reach overhead. Three more, come down. Walk it out, plank. Bring it in, overhead. Two more, down into a squat. Walk it out, you got this. Bring it back in, one last time. Now we're gonna stay out here. I want 10 push-ups. Remember, you can do these from your knees for beginners, but I want you to see how many you can get from your toes. Elbows wide, 45 degrees between your torso and this arm, okay? Let's go. Breathe it out. You got it. Two more. One more time, I'm with you. Now hands under your shoulders. We're gonna get the abs a little more involved. Pike the hips up. Bring your hand and touch your opposite ankle. Then come back to your plank. Switch hands. Pike and touch. Now give me eight more. Abs in and reach. Engage the core, lift the hips up and reach across. Breathe it out. You got this. We're working the arms, the core, the shoulders, the back, everything, my friends. This is total body. Keep it going. Hips up. Use that core to lift the hips up. Give me two more. Oh, I know you're warm now. One more time. Yes. Hold the plank. If you need to take a break, just drop the knees down. Turn to your side, core is tight, side plank, and breathe here. 15 seconds together, we got this. Keep the hips up nice and high. Modification, all you have to do is drop that knee down, okay? Listen to your body. And the other side. Turn the feet, hips up, no dropping the hips down. Core is tight, reach that arm up, 15 seconds. and back to center. Drop the knees and just stretch it out. Good job. Moving on. We're gonna hit the core a little bit more. Back up into the plank, bringing the knee across to the opposite elbow, okay? Core is tight. Lift the knee off the floor, across. If you can't get the full range, that's totally fine. Just go the range you can. Keep the abs tight, rotate those hips, and cross. Give me 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, yes, 2, one more. And everybody, forearm plank. Brace the core as tight as you can. Imagine someone's trying to punch you in the stomach and you're resisting, squeezing that core tight. Come on, keep breathing out, keep contracting the abs. Give me 10 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, take a break. Good job, cat, cow. Push away to the floor. Excellent. Two more, cat, cow. Good. Now start in a down dog position. We're gonna go through four yoga poses that all target the upper body and the core. So the first one's the down dog. Fingertips are wide. Push your chest towards your thighs. Push your hips up to the sky. Press the heels towards the floor. So you get a nice stretch through the Achilles and the hamstrings, but you are working your upper body in this position. And give me two more deep breaths. Then come to a plank position. Brace your core nice and tight. Then slowly, elbows into your side. We lower all the way down to the floor until you're flat. And that's your chaturanga. Roll your shoulders back and come up into an up dog. See if you can lift the thighs off the floor. Tops of the feet into the ground and then back to the down dog. You got this. Let's try it again. Deep breath, inhale. Exhale, sink deeper in your down dog. Now inhale to your plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Two more, you got this. You ready? Give me one more breath here. Inhale to plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. One last time. Inhale to plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And now slowly walk your hands into your feet. Roll it up one vertebra at a time. Grab your light weights. I'm gonna start with fives and we're gonna do lunges in three different directions. So the weight you need to do a front lunge, a side lunge, and a reverse lunge. I'm gonna do fives. You lift the weight you feel is comfortable for you, okay? So core is tight. Step forward with your left foot and drive the weight into the heel of the foot. So no driving forward into your knee, okay? Step forward, land on the heel, lower down into a lunge. Then push back to the start position. Then side lunge, step the foot out. Sit the weight into the heel, push your butt back. Same bicep curl. The other leg is straight. Push through the heel to stand back up. And now reverse lunge. Step back, lower down into that lunge, and come back to the start. Okay, let's do this. Shoulders back and front lunge. Land in the heel, chest up. Side lunge. Reverse lunge. Same leg. Forward, front lunge. Side lunge. Reverse lunge. Again, step forward, land on the heel, chest up. Side lunge. Reverse lunge. Again, forward lunge, keep that knee behind the toe, the chest up tall, and always driving through the heel of the foot, okay? On that front lunge and on the side lunge, you're driving through the heel. The back lunge, you drive through the heel of the front leg. You're like, how many is she gonna make us do? Oh my God, I can feel it in my legs. Oh, just a few more. Gets the heart rate up, right? It's awesome for those legs. Moving in all these three different directions is also amazing for the pelvis wall. Yes, so all you women who've had babies and you have to get that pelvis wall nice and strong, lunging in different directions every time you step away from the center of gravity, that pelvis wall goes whoop, and you have to really work it to keep it strong. One more time. Nice.